Myself, Swanand Thorve. I am from Bed District, working in Ashti Taluka. I conducted 3 tag meetings every month, 25 teachers in each tag, and nearly about 60 tag meetings I have conducted till today. So today's presenting this presentation, I choose the subject using poems in lessons. So what is the importance of the poem and how can we conduct them into our classrooms? So please next. So what I learned in a tag. So first, I increase my confidence and I'm motivational from the tag meeting. Because of that I get. I use many techniques, ideas and activities, including all that 3 sections, means language development, learning by reading and learning by watching, that 3, and warmers also. So that helps me to increase my English language. What went well? Using warmers and using poem is the best in my classrooms, because I have a lot of confidence while I am taking them into my classrooms. So that went very well. Poems are essential part of the language. I think that poem create a beautiful atmosphere in your classrooms. It is a recipe. If you speak a lot, then your students become so boring and thinking that teacher is going to be speak. But when you use poem with actions, it is very effective for the students. And importance of the poems and types of the poems. As I learned by the British Council, chants are there, poems are there, and rhymes are there. These are the types of poems. Some are very small and some are very big. So that I have used in my lessons, and that is very effective for me. So what I did in my classroom, I use poems in lessons and sometimes as warmers. For Up the Ladder is very effective poem in my classroom. For example, I am going to sing Up the Ladder and Down the Slide. A merry-go-round, let's take a ride. Here's a swing, they understood. Here's a swing, go to and fro, bounce the seesaw high and low. So it effect on that is a bounce, and they get a lot of enjoy while they are making dance. So that very important thing in the poem my students learn. I sang these poems time to time from previous standards. Old syllabus has very some beautiful poems. For example, Up with the Sun. If you know, Up with the Sun, I am on my way, rushing to my school, it's the opening day. Holidays are over, but I'm not at all sad. And at the last line, there is a tongue twister. It was old and good as gold, friends of mine. So they are not able to speak good, 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 good. But after day by day, I gave a lot of chance. For practicing, they understand the last lines. I gave verb related actions for, this is my poem. I create that poem for my students. Tap your head and bend your head. Tap your nose and pull your nose. Pull, even that is only action. There is no anything in their nose. Then tap your cheek and press your cheek. Tap your shoulders and move. Bounce your shoulders. Tap your waist and move it around. Tap your waist. Tap your feet. Tap your feet and take your seat. So they sit down on their place. That is the poem for my students, which created me for getting joy for myself and my students themselves. I change tempo. Tempo means speed of the poem. In the third standard book, there is a poem. 6 little mice sat down to spin. Pussy passed by and she peeped in. What are you doing, my little men? Weaving coats for gentlemen. Shall I come in and cut up your threads? No, miss pussy, you'd bite up our heads. Oh no, I will not. I will help you to spin. That may be so, but you don't come in. So there is a little bit change in the speed of the poem that create interest in my lesson. Sir, please. Next. How it went? I used poems from textbook from grade 1 to 8. As I am a teacher of 6 to 8 standard, but I use little standard, little grade poems also. Suppose there is a rainy season in my school. That day I use poem rain come again, or rain on the green grass, rain on the tree, rain on the house top but not on me, or row your boat gently down the That poem helps to understand the atmosphere, and they tried to connect the words with the situation. So that helps my students in my classroom. Students are always curious and enthusiastic. They have a lot of questions. While they are listening the poem, they have some questions. And after the poem, they ask in their mother tongue. Sometimes they try to ask in English, but they are not 100% able to speak in English. Actions help understand the meaning of the poem. In first standard, there is a very good poem. I like it most. For example, clap your hands. Action. Clap. Clap means they understand. Clap your hands. Clap your hands. Listen to the music and clap your hands. Stamp your feet. Stamp. What do you mean stamp? Your feet. Listen to the music and stamp your feet. Turn around. They around. Take a round. Turn around. Listen to the music and turn around. Jump up high. So action. Jump. They understood the jump. For that. Then students enjoy the poems. I wrote some poems for my students. Come with a run. That is another one poem that I wrote for my students. What they have to be do in their classrooms. There is some rules, some etiquettes used in this poem for my students, and I use when they feeling bored. Please next. Some poems have no rhyme. It is difficult for the teachers, so they cannot sing. This is the reflection about myself and my student self. Students find difficulty to make poems. They are not able to frame new poems, but I gave them chance. Write down anything and I will say, yes, you are right. That is the first step of framing the poems. I would try to sing these poems with music. I am not very well, but I am trying these two poems which have no rhythm with the music. For low learners, rhyme in poem is important. So first grade, second grade, third grade and fourth grade, rhyme is essential. It's my opinion. I will try and use poems to teach some language aspect too. I am trying to make new poems for my students. Nearly about 20 poems I made for my students, and it is very good for my students. So tips for other teachers. Use poems as warmer activities in the classrooms. Use other standards poem too. Try to form or create your new poems. Give the appropriate actions to the songs. You chant rhymes and songs too. I want to tell you, if you want to teach them something, think about yourself and do your own creation. For example, I want to teach them some animals and their work. I wrote a poem. Elephant dada, what do you do? Bola, what do you do? I eat green grass and walk very slow. Monkey bhau, what do you do? Sangha, what do you do? I swing on a tree and jump from a tree. Manni meow, what do you do? Bola, what do you do? I drink sweet milk and take deep sleep. Kau mai, what do you do? Sangha, what do you do? I give you milk and graze on a hill. So this poem is very famous in my students, and they understood different. And if you listen carefully, there is one chapter, learning by reading, bilingual. Bola, bola means Marathi, but in English we can say tell. Monkey bhau, bhau means brother. Elephant dada, dada means brother. So use some Marathi words in the poem to create interest about the students. Next. Okay. So if you have any question in my presentation, I would like to ask you, please ask me. Do you have any question about the using poems in the lesson? It is very important that poem is a very useful part in the lessons. Sir, do you have anyone, please? Yes, sir. Wow. Very good.
The presentation was really good, but I want to know the difference
between chants. Yes, sir. Johnny, yes, Papa is coming into the chant because there are only short four lines. In Marathi, we can say mantra. Chant means mantra. Repeating. Om Bhur Bhuvasva Tasya Vitur Varenam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Viyayana Prachodayat. So that is a chant. And rhyme means the poem which has rhyme. And poem means a lot of thing. You cannot imagine it.